Mustang Connection. I am at SEMA 2016. Lots to come, of course, mostly Mustangs, but a lot of really cool, unique stuff as always. So thanks for watching. See y'all soon.
Hi, I'm Jason with Classic Recreations. We're here at SEMA 2016. We're showing off our latest and greatest creation. This is the GT350CR. It's a 1966-based original car we've converted into a Shelby with all the aesthetics and things we're going to talk about today.
So let's start in the front, and so just a quick note, guys, we're at American Racing Wheel right here. Beautiful display. Unfortunately, because of insurance rules, we cannot roll this out. So I'm going to show you some great photography, and Jason's going to share this build, but I've shown you some of his other cars in the past from SEMA, and this thing is spectacular. So I'll get you some photos of it in totality, but he's going to lift the hood and show you what's doing on the business end here, which is pretty awesome. This custom hood, let's talk about that. I mean, right off the bat.
This is actually, it comes from the Shelby CS8 or Terlingua car. It's a deep draw hood. What happens is the air obviously comes off the windshield. It actually sucks heat out of the engine bay. What we've done, this is the new 2016-17 Coyote with the 5.2 Voodoo intake. What this allows this engine to do is perform at higher RPM. So you can shift this one to 8,200 RPMs, and I'm putting down 480 horsepower to the ground.
So for lack of a better term, you've taken a Coyote, mixed it with a Voodoo intake, and you have a Coyote Voodoo. Yeah,
yes,
that revs to Voodoo type numbers.
Absolutely.
Which is exclusive to, at this point anyway, the new GT350 and GT350R. So really cool that the engine and the... What about recalibrating? Obviously, it has to be recalibrated. The ECM has to be recalibrated.
Yes, all of our tunes are done by JDM. We work with them, give them data logs. We have a dyno at our shop. We give them all the data, then they build the tune for the car. Something unique about any of our cars is a returnless fuel system. Rather than running a return that's running the pump consistently all the time, we use a returnless fuel system with PTFE line. So it's a Teflon-coated line, doesn't permeate any kind of fuel smell. And we use a VaporWorks module to drive that. So it's basically ran by RPM, slows the pump down, speeds it up. Real simple, keeps the fuel cool, and performance is definitely, you can build in the CD pants.
Yeah, it looks like almost a factory build in here. He mentioned, also Jason mentioned, this is a serialized car that goes in the
Shelby registry.
And this is this started life as a real
66
fastback.
Yes, it did.
We were talking about this. You can bring him your car, or they have one there for you, and 65 through 68.
Correct.
In a variety of different custom builds.
Yes.
This one happens to be the 350 CR. You want to talk? Let's talk about anything else under the hood. I mean, there's so much going on. I mean, obviously all the modern accoutrement. I mean,
you know, it really, really. Besides the drivetrain, what really sets this car apart on this particular car is the Detroit speed upgrade. This has got the Aluma frame, which is similar to like a C7 Corvette underneath the 66 Mustang. It's got 8 degrees of caster and handles.
So it's more like a full frame car versus the typical unibody that's been reinforced with some support.
That is correct.
So the ultimate when it comes to adjustability and things like that.
It is. I mean, the handling on this car is just insane.
Like it's on rails.
It really is.
So you're using a cable clutch.
I do on all my cars. It's great you asked that question.
Why not hydraulic?
I get this all the time. I've had so many hydraulic draw bearings fail. Anytime they fail, liquid comes out, hydraulic fluid all over your clutch.
You have no clutch, you can't shift, yeah.
This is a tried and true method I've used for 12 years with no failure.
And they run 18s. Again, it gives it a sinister look without being cartoony or over the top. And I'm kind of speaking now because we just went over the car, but you want to talk about how cool the little wheel tubs back here are? And
yeah, so we mini tub.
Say little, look at the size of the rim, right?
It's an 18 by 11 with a 315/30/18. That's a BF Goodrich Rival tire, which handles excellent, by the way. But to get it to fit in the car. Basically, you have to add another torque box inside the factory torque box and move the control arms inboard, okay? Then we use Detroit Speed's tub kit, which I thought looked really clean, and it's not too intrusive, in order to allow it. And really, there's a lot of clearance in this car. I mean, it's kind of strange. We didn't know how it was going to fit.
So, I know there's a lot of reflection and glare from the back window, but I'm not sure if you can see, but I'll point here, my fancy pointer. This barely takes up any of the rear package tray, and this kind of has a 66 style package or 65 style R code package tray in the back, so you have kind of usable space back here.
It is.
And Kicker Audio is your Absolutely. Is your audio supplier.
That's our supplier. We've used them. What's unique about them is you're sitting here running a 500 watt amp, it's got a small footprint. It's because it's digital. It's not gigantor, you know, you're not taking up a bunch of trunk room, and it sounds incredible.
So the other thing too, they've got they've taken out the rods and springs that normally control, and they've got a little
gas shock,
a little shock in here, and their custom badging. Again, this is in the registry. The build quality is amazing. It's
for
a lot of touches that, again, without going around the entire car, but you can see it's got the bumper's obviously painted to match, and the detail goes all the way through here. It's Frenched in, and it falls all the way down to lower valence. Really clean, there's no cutouts for exhaust because they're side exhaust, functioning side exhaust. With MagnaFlow, correct?
Yes.
Plexiglass.
We took a factory 66 Shelby side window kit, and then we painted the trim, and we cut our own plexiglass in a tinted version, and I think it really changed it up. It gives it, like you said, that sinister look. But really, it's 66 technology.
It is. Now, if someone wanted to keep their vents, they could?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And we'll build it anyway. We have some guys that request a stripe delete or a different style of wheel. We're not against doing that. We're willing to build whatever the customer really wants.
Well, we made it this far. Unfortunately, next door, it sounds like a jackhammer. That's not. That's somebody on one of those, not the English wheel, like the air hammer.
Yes, it is.
So I'll do my best. I'm going to actually have him walk back around because the light's a little better. I want to show the inside, and we'll talk about the Apple Play system the car has. It's got this cool, the side vents, the brake ducts, are they functional?
They are not functional because we use a 14-inch rotor.
Oh, and it's inboard really, a little bit.
Yes, sir. Yeah, you'd be blowing air on the tires.
Yeah. And then is the front fender flared a little bit? Is that it?
Yes.
So these, you can see it does actually come out a little bit. Yeah, and these are fiberglass, correct? They're molded in?
Right, it's a steel fender with a fiberglass flare. So great. We use a TKO 600. I like a 5-speed better behind the Coyotes. They're a little longer legged versus your 6-speed. You're not shifting so much. The unique thing about this interior, I believe, is the Apple CarPlay JVC touchscreen head unit. So basically, with your microphone located over here, you're able to use Siri as an assistant. All the way, and it's hands-free. So you're driving down the road, you want a text message, you want to set a calendar, you want a GPS location, you want reviews on a restaurant. It's amazing what it'll do. And it's such a small touch, but yet I believe my end user is going to use it a lot.
So it's, again, one of those modern touches that's been incorporated into the build.
Yes.
And someone has, that's an option, right? They don't have to have it if they don't want it.
Correct. That is correct. Yeah, you don't, this is an option here to have. We've obviously deleted the radio location here and moved it down here. In a standard setting, you would have your two-knob radio here, but it's more, it's a digital radio with an iPod plug-in or a USB plug-in in the dash.
And then custom touches, it's got the Shelby script, you know, up here, and
I kind of toned down the interior a little bit on these. It's not so bright with logos everywhere. I thought the soft touch of the signatures was nice.
And then these are Pro Car seats?
Yes, Pro Car 1000s. They're great seats. Of course, cam lock style. It's really easy to get in and out. I love them. I use them on all of our cars. One thing, too. The headliner, if you notice, it's an ABS.
Is that
headliner.
One piece? Yeah.
Yes. This is an added touch, and you get an extra, you know, 2 inches of headroom.
That's a lot.
All right, Jason, want to talk about the steering setup, and then I know it's a Detroit Speed subframe setup.
Yes.
On this.
Yeah,
but let's talk about braking and steering and kind of how they're all married together.
What I use the Detroit Speed power rack. The brakes are the Wilwood six-piston brakes that we have built for us for this system. You can't get any better than that. It's an ABS electronic brake. Master.
Really?
Cylinder. Yes. So you have, it's pretty cool. You have brakes with the key on. You don't have to have a car running.
Right.
It's an electronic system, and it works really, really well. And the car will throw you through the windshield.
And then this is a, we were just talking, this is a chrome-plated Flaming River tilt setup in here.
Yeah, I use Flaming River because they're a collapsible column. They build them to length for us. And really, they're a great supplier. They've been really good to us.
So that's funny you mention that, because we were just talking about, we're at SEMA, and there are a million names you've heard and seen in magazines and on TV. There are very few manufacturers, I'd say very few, but there are some that really know what they're doing and really get it right. Magnaflow and
yes.
Flaming River. And to have a supplier you trust, especially, and if you're talking about a builder like Jason, you know, they're tried and true. They know what works in these cars. That makes a heck of a lot. They're taking the experiment out for you. So, I mean, that says a lot. So you want a car that's got this kind of horsepower to be safe and fast and reliable, and that's what you're buying.
Yes.
That's what you're paying a premium for, is a quality build that does all the things you want it to do, like a modern car should. The console is just built in. I mean, it's just seamless in with the carpet. It looks so cool.
Yeah, I have these built by Mustang Pony Cars in Canada. And for this particular car, because I was trying to tone the interior down, I did all black leather in the middle as well. So it's just all sleek and clean with a matching hook and loop carpet on the sides. I think it really blends well.
It does. It looks amazing. It really does.
Thank you.